The objective of a minimum wage system is to guarantee a stable income level for workers. The Korean government has made consistent efforts to raise the minimum wage. In 2018, it has increased the wage by a large margin with a goal to achieve the 10,000 won mark by 2020. So what would be the consequences of such a sharp increase? A higher minimum wage pushes up not only wages at the bottom, but also those near the bottom, narrowing the wage gap and improving income distribution. During the last 5 years, Korea has seen a gradual increase in the minimum wage and a narrowing of income disparity as wages at the bottom are pushed up with the minimum wage increase. On the other hand, higher wages mean higher costs for business owners. In response to minimum wage increases, businesses may raise product prices, or reduce working hours, or cut benefits. If wages continue to increase and the cost rise becomes unbearable, businesses will reduce their employees. Then, will an increase in the minimum wage actually lead to job losses in the future? KDI examined the anticipated job losses inferred from economic theories and experiences from overseas. In the US, a 10% rise in the minimum wage generally resulted in a modest 0.15% job decrease. But the minimum wage is higher in Korea than in the US as a ratio to the median wage. Consequently, the negative effect is likely to be larger in Korea. Hungary has raised its minimum wage by a surprising 60% during the 4 years since 2000. The result was a large decrease of jobs, as much as 2% of total number of jobs. In France, the minimum wage is set as high as 61% of the median wage. In this case, wages are leveled out, and workers experience no wage rise in their first 10 years of career, weakening their work incentives. Korea's minimum wage increased by 16.4% in 2018 from the previous year. If we apply the estimates from the US, the rise would involve a job loss of 36,000 workers. If Hungary's case is applied, the job loss would be 84,000 workers. These figures correspond to 0.2 and 0.4% of total employment and are not considered as big numbers. In fact, up to April, the employment statistics have not shown any significant decline of jobs among the youth under age 25 or women in the 50s, who are the major minimum wage worker groups. Further, there is no clear evidence that wholesale and retail jobs and restaurants and lodging jobs have reduced due to the minimum wage increase. This could be owing to the government subsidies, which has been provided to buffer the shocks. Then what would happen if the minimum wage is to increase by 15% in 2019 and again in 2020? It is expected that workers affected by the minimum wage hike will increase from 8.7% in 2017 to 28% in 2020. Also, the minimum wage will reach 68% of the median wage by 2020. Indeed, if the impact from the minimum wage increase expands, businesses may have to cut down their labor significantly. An estimation of the job loss using Hungary's example reveals that job loss figures would mark 84,000 in 2018, 96,000 in 2019, and 144,000 in 2020. These figures do not take the government's wage subsidies and possible institutional changes into consideration, and the actual size of job loss may not be as pronounced as anticipated.
최저임금의 대폭 인상에 따른 우려에도 불구하고 지금까지는 큰 부작용 없이 안착되고 있습니다. 저임금 근로자의 임금을 개선하고자 했던 원래의 목적도 성과를 거두고 있습니다. 그렇지만 최저임금의 효과는 앞으로 얼마나 빨리 인상되느냐, 그리고 최저임금에 해당되는 근로자가 얼마나 많으냐에 따라 달라집니다. 2020년에 1만 원에 도달하기 위해서 내년에 15% 인상된다면 최저임금은 임금 중간값의 60%로 추가적으로 인상되면 이보다 더 높아지게 됩니다. 이렇게 되면 득보다 실이 많아질 수도 있습니다. 그러므로 인상폭을 조절하는 방안도 최저임금 인상의 안착에 큰 도움이 될 것입니다.